What's going on, everybody? Asad Hashmali here, back again with another episode of Behind the Grind, the podcast where we interview people who are doing cool things on a regular basis. I was trying to keep that kosher for a second. Otherwise, I usually say people who do cool shit on a regular basis. But that's what we're all about, listening to stories, hearing people about their passions, about their grind, about what keeps them up at night, and just having a good conversation overall. Today, I have with me a guest, and this guest is a little younger than me. The point of doing these podcasts was not to get people older than me, but the point of these podcasts was basically to just hear people's stories, you know, hear the truth about things. And today, I have Ahad Hakim.
Hello.
Ahad, what's up?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Good, good, good. The reason why I called Ahad on, the reason why I called you on, was not because you just happened to have swung by to the office and decided to meet me, but was because I actually thought about doing a podcast with someone who's in A-levels right now, or someone closer to that age, and in high school in general, and get inside their heads. It's been six, seven years since I got out of high school, and I was actually thinking of doing a monologue on this, and reflecting on my time back then, thinking about how I was going through things, thinking about the things that I picked up on, things that I practiced on my own, and how that might help other people, like even something as such as managing finances back then also. So Ahad, tell me a little bit about yourself. I know about you, but tell the people over here a little bit about yourself.
I don't really have much experience.
How do you know me? How are you in my life?
Well, basically, I came to Cedar. And at first, I was a science student, but I changed it during the interview process.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. I was O-levels mein pura science student. I had a goal to be a geologist. Ki mujhe thoda environmental sciences mein jana tha.
Really?
Yeah. But then in the interview,
yeah.
So they didn't have any science courses available. Science subjects available, because I was literally interviewed the day of the orientation.
Oh, so all the seats were full, basically.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So I was interviewed 6 hours before the orientation, and I didn't even have a uniform yet. And they told me that we don't really have space in chemistry and physics.
Okay.
So I was like, I didn't really like sciences at the time.
Okay.
But I didn't see myself doing anything else.
Okay.
So at that very moment, I decided ke yahan to main privately karunga.
Okay.
Or I should just change everything and go towards sociology, because I was really interested in that at the time.
Yeah.
So I chose psychology, sociology, and aise dukke mein media studies.
So it's literally that random.
Yeah.
It's like, not like you spent.
Nahin, I didn't really plan on it. Like pura irada tha sciences mein jaun, agar sciences mein nahi hai to sociology mein jaun, bas ye mera plan tha.
Really? So if I was to ask you, how long did it take you to make that decision, how long did it really take you?
Well, in that scenario, in that situation, I already was like, yeah, two way street hai, ya sciences ya phir sociology.
Yeah.
Yeah. Aur main dono karna chah raha tha, ki main science subjects bhi lu aur ek sociology le lu main. But science subjects the nahi.
Yeah.
So I decided on thoda humanities ki taraf jaun. So I just went with psychology and sociology aur media studies, kyunki aur koi subject tha nahi. At first it was business.
Okay.
Main pehle business liya tha, but I dropped it kyunki I don't know, man, like it wasn't for me.
Not my vibe.
Yeah, it wasn't like teacher bure the. Sir Salman teacher bahut acche. Shout out. Lekin I just felt like it wasn't for me.
Fair?
Business. Yeah. So I took media studies because I was already like, you know, a photographer at the time.
Yeah.
Main 8th grade se photography kar raha. And I was like, chalo media studies kar lete hain. Aise like, you know that subject.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's like aise kar raha. Main subject to sociology or psychology the.
Yeah.
And at the time ye meri opinion thi.
That's very interesting. I had no clue about it. And yeah. This is, so for all those listening, when Ahad was in A-levels, Ahad was a student of Cedar College and graduated in the class of 2019.
Yes.
Yes. And his media studies class was at 9 a.m. and it would end at 10 a.m. And his classroom was literally, it was at 8 a.m. and it would end at 9 a.m.?
At AS, my classes were from 1 till 4.
No, but I'm talking about A2. In your final year, you had a morning class.
Yeah.
And your morning class for media studies was literally right outside my office.
Yep.
And before and after his class, he would come to me and start whining about school.
Yep.
Or he would come and complain about something or the other.
No one listened. I didn't have any friends at the time. I was like, oh, that guy. This old man.
Let's talk to him.
So you were legit right outside the class window. And you always came and was like, hi. AS, I didn't really know you that well.
I knew you as Sanya's cousin.
I'm not really your cousin, like distant cousin. Distant cousin. And the first time I actually talked to you was AS mein.
Yeah.
Media studies ki class mein, you gave like a small...
A little demo.
Cheats in filmmaking.
Yeah.
So usi I was like, hey, ye bhi filmmaking karna chahte hain. And at the time, I was like, media acha lagne laga mujhe.
Okay.
So I was not like... I should be his friend.
Network. Let's start building the tribe. Yeah, good.
I didn't know what networking was. I was like, dude, I want to meet that guy or pata nahi kya. Because in the first day of Cedar, I thought you were like, I don't know, a principal.
Some overgrown student? A principal?
I don't know. I didn't really know Cedar at that time. I talked to the seniors. They said director ka system tha. Yeah. I had no idea what even a director was.
Right.
Like, I was O-levels mein, principal, headmistress.
You came in from a very like rudimentary system and then having to see something like that.
Yeah.
Fair enough. But actually, I want to ask you something about your life prior to A-levels. You mentioned this CAS mein, you were at CAS, yeah?
Yeah.
So there's this principal, headmistress, headmistress. So back then, you said you wanted to be a geologist, but like other than that's something really sick, by the way. I think that's really cool. But like what got you to think of that? And if that was also something equally random as you choosing sociology, psychology, media studies, then what were your goals or your aspirations back then?
At the time in O levels, it's kind of weird, but my ultimate goal, like, जो मैं अपने दिमाग के हर वक्त आगे रखता था इट्स नॉट टू गेट हेल्ड बैक दैट वॉज माई गोल लाइक जस्ट पास हो जाऊँ आई हैड शिट ग्रेड्स इन ओ लेवल्स लाइक मैं 50% वाला स्टूडेंट था लाइक बॉर्डर लाइन
या जस्ट गेटिंग बाय
या ऑलमोस्ट एवरी सब्जेक्ट इवन लाइक इन साइंसेज आई वॉजंट रियली दैट गुड लाइक आई वॉज एवरेज एट बेस्ट तो मेरा यही गोल था कि नॉट टू गेट हेल्ड बैक आई डोंट वांट टू रिपीट माय ईयर like my grade in O levels to ye mera tha but geology mein there was this one subject called environmental management so I really it came naturally to me like the subject was really interesting and it just came naturally to me miss Talat thi I don't remember her last name to wo padhati thi very sweet teacher bahut achhi teacher thi and she told me environmental sciences comes naturally to you. Maybe you should look into that. So I just did a little bit of research and found geology. Basically, I did some research on, you know, a career in geology. Not much in Pakistan except going into the oil field.
Yeah.
So I wanted to do international. So I was like, oh, let's be a geologist. And at the time, even though I love sociology, I felt like environmental sciences came naturally to me, so that's what I should do.
Okay.
Because I didn't want anything. I wasn't as passionate about it, but I was really like into it. So after that, after O levels, I was like, I want to be a geologist. Then Cedar came. Seats nahi thi, thank God seats nahi thi, and I would be struggling abhi. So, yeah, I think that's where my life turned.
Sweet. Yeah.
So, my sister, she was actually in sociology ke side pe ja rahi thi. She was in university at the time.
Okay.
So, I was like, I can work with my sister. And she can help me and I can help her and stuff. Yeh wo mindset tha.
Cool.
So, AS mein pura sociology ka tha. But in mid AS, I was like, oh shit, I really like filmmaking.
Yeah.
So Miss Seerat Jafri, she made me fall in love with filmmaking and the production side.
Yeah, yeah.
So I didn't really watch films at the time, but us subject ke baad, I just fell in love with filmmaking. So I was like, want to be a filmmaker or like just create something.
And this is what got you to then end up pursuing a major in film, right?
Yep.
Sweet.
Abhi main IOBM mein media studies kar raha.
Main nahi bolunga CBM, meri jaan, don't worry.
Shut up. I like IOBM, man.
No, great. Because one of your faculty members and head of the program, Naban, solid guy. And I love the effort that he's putting in. Someone from my team also is a student of Naban's as well. Hmm. And I've met Naban a few times, and I haven't heard anyone ever question the guy's skill, ability, knowledge, personality. I think he's just like too good to be true sometimes, you know?
Yeah, he's awesome, yeah. Like, yeah. He's given me more exposure than I think I'll ever get anywhere else.
And that's, honestly speaking, I really love hearing that, is because you've managed to find people who you're gravitating towards that you know are going to help you set yourself up in a good way, or that actually who you can feed off from as well. It's very hard to find, no, I'm not saying, I don't mean to say like-minded individuals, but it's very hard to find genuine heroes for yourself that you know, okay, yaar, ye banda na, matlab, ye nahi ki kaam aayega. But ye banda meri madad kar sakta hai, and isko pata hai ki kya karna
hai. I can learn something from him, exactly. Like something useful.
Exactly. But sorry, one question about you growing up.
Hmm.
You now, after your media studies class in A-levels, that's what really inspired you to get into film, yeah? So back when you were a kid, did you ever feel that you had like a creative bone in you, or that you would catch yourself, you know, daydreaming and thinking you were Shah Rukh Khan in the middle of like geography class or Islamiyat or something like that? Not in Islamiyat, because, you know, that's not the way to go about that class. But like in literature, maybe, for example, you would imagine yourself being Macbeth?
Well, when I was really young, I was really into like art, like painting, sketching, etc. I did it as like a hobby, like bahut. I was really young, like even before 8th grade. But during 8th grade, hamara ek ECA tha, photography ke liye. So I was like, yeah, I want to go into photography. I don't know why. I thought that I was like, mujhe photography karna hai. So I went to the photography, and they didn't really have seats at the time. So I literally begged them. At the time, I was really young, okay? So don't judge me. But I went to the office and cried, because I wanted photography that bad. And yeah.
No, did you get your mom involved in this?
No.
No.
She doesn't know about this.
Take that as a man. Did it yourself.
No, because she's like, she would have been like, why? Just take it next year.
Yeah.
I was like, nahi, mujhe abhi chahiye. Because I was really like, you know.
Ziddi.
Ziddi, yeah. Fair. Really ziddi. So I took photography, or usse bahut kuch seekha, and ever since then I've been doing photography. 8th grade se ab tak photography kar raha hu. I still remember my first teacher, Amna Ansari. She was an IVS student, and I don't know, I met her after that. I met her once in Karachi 2 years ago.
She remembered you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, they.
Cool.
So yeah, and after photography karte raha, that was my creative aspect. And people really liked it. One disadvantage was ke jo bhi school event hota tha, it wasn't by the school, but like mere sare batchmates kehte the, you're gonna do the photography. And at every event, like even till the last, you know, batch party school mein jo hoti
hai. Yeah, yeah, the graduation.
Yeah, no, not the graduation, like beforehand.
Okay.
To uski puri photos maine le li. And I realized meri koi photo nahi liya. Mere saath koi bhi photo liya. I was like, oh shit. Then I realized mujhe event photography zindagi mein kabhi nahi karni. I know mujhe karni padegi, but
no, man, yeah. If it's my event, then I especially don't want to have to do it. Yeah,
exactly.
That makes sense, you know. It'd be weird if you were doing wedding photography, and at your own wedding, you're also doing your photography as well.
To be honest,
that's messed up then.
Log bolenge, tum kyun nahi kare wedding photography? I'm like, bhai, meri shaadi mein aayo. Thank
you. Tum log meri tasveer lo.
Exactly.
Yeah. But another question about you entering CEDAR is that, Did it not cross? I still can't get over the fact is that this was that quick of a decision, you know, because you could have gone private, all right? And when I was in A-levels, I think also, I think this conversation for me is even more insightful is because it takes me back to my past. Even though I can say that, you know, 6 saal pehle maine A-levels kiya, that's nothing, but it feels like a lot.
Hmm.
All right, especially at how fast time has flown. But I just think that when I was in A-levels, then I had this idea is that if I didn't get into Lyceum, there was no CETA at that time.
Yeah.
I didn't want to go to Nixer. I didn't want to go to KGS, even if I got the grades. I didn't get the grades, but it was tha. So it was like either Lyceum or Bayview. And the reason why I chose Lyceum was for a couple of reasons. The first reason was that if I'd be in a group of excellent individuals, I would, you know, perform at my best. I would be pushed to excel, and then I would end up at a great university, and then trajectory solid ho jati hai aapki. And even the subject combination was always something which was of big concern to me. I decided early on was that I'm not going to do accounts in A-levels, but I'm going to do economics, psychology, and math. Now people question that combination, but for me that was something which I feel has worked in my benefit, is because even though I graduated with a degree in economics and finance, the psychology that I studied back then has helped me understand organizational behavior now, even though I didn't do a single course about OB in university or HR. So it's just basically that combination, that subject combination. Then also hamari to us time bhi phatti thi ki yaar, what combination of subjects are you going to take that a university will accept? Because you have this stigma that you do Urdu in A-levels, you ain't going to know university abroad.
Yeah.
You know? Or you do something like dance and photography in your A-levels, then again, like, you can then go to those particular niches. Did it not cross your mind ke yaar, what trajectory you would have for university? There was a risk factor, no, involved. Or am I just feeding too into it?
Well, I actually planned this. Ke na, agar sciences mein nahi mile, मैं सोशियोलॉजी में जाऊंगा, ह्यूमैनिटीज़ में. ये मैंने लाइक सबको बोल दिया, पेरेंट्स को भी बोल दिया कि अगर मुझे साइंसेस अच्छा नहीं लगे, आई एम गोइंग टू सोशियोलॉजी. दे वर हेजिटेंट एट फर्स्ट, लेकिन दे एक्सेप्टेड. माय पेरेंट्स आर रियली चिल अबाउट दैट. लेकिन एट द टाइम लाइक पूरा इरादा था कि सोशियोलॉजी करूँगा. आई एम गोना डू मेजर्स इन, I don't know, political science from Zabist. Pura plan banaya tha maine.
So there was actually like a bit of you which wanted you to not get the science seats.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. I didn't cool. like sciences, man.
No, that's really, that's admirable, man, that you were prepared.
At the time, everyone was going into sciences, na? Like, yeah. Half of my friend list was like, sciences mein jayenge, A-levels mein. Or prayer, you know, koi science ki degree karenge, like,
because it's a safer route now.
Yeah.
You know, you have those past experiences in front of you.
Exactly. Or at the time, no one really thought about, you know, like other paths.
Yeah.
So sociology main bhi kar raha tha na, if my sister wasn't there, then I wouldn't have thought about sociology. Because she has done sociology. So.
But that exposure from the family exists beforehand.
Yeah.
So you had a reference point,
yeah,
basically.
A reference point, yeah.
Fair, cool. So haji bole.
Yeah.
Yeah, may I?
Yeah, yeah.
So tell me a little bit about the people who you hung out with.
In O levels?
In A levels.
A levels.
Yeah, and chalo fine in O levels as well.
Yeah, O levels mein. I mean, I was there was only like, you know, in my batch, I used to hang out with everyone.
Okay.
But
social butterfly.
Yeah. I abhi, to be honest.
When I caterpillar?
I was kind of fake.
Really?
Yeah. Abhi, when I realized it, though, I used to try to impress everyone.
Okay.
I wasn't in one group. 11th grade, mein, I finally found some people who I could call my group. Lekin after O levels, you know, everyone went their separate ways.
Yeah, yeah.
Kuch log abroad chale gaye, kuch log yahan par rahe, but we lost contact.
Yeah.
So yeah, but in A levels, I realized ke who I want to be friends with. For Sorry. Example, like AS mein, like I was, it was a completely new environment, different people, and I didn't know how to make friends. So I was like, but it's a fresh start. I can present myself as a new
Ahad 2.0.
Yeah, new Ahad.
Yeah.
So I started to, like, you know, become friends with everyone to see, like, you know, kiske saath banti hai meri.
Yeah.
Or after like bahut mahine, I stuck with my O level friends who came to Cedar at the time. And then I found other people. It's not like I didn't keep in touch with them. But I found other people who had like similar interests, similar career paths, maybe. Even in like media studies. Deena Kamal. So after that, I met like friends that, you know, really got me, like knew how to, like, I could be myself in front of them. Varna in O levels I was like, you know, trying to please everyone.
So in the past you caught yourself trying to get everyone's approval.
Wanted to be the popular.
You want to be the popular kid.
In A levels, AS mein, like kuch.
You want everyone assign your yearbook. Then later on you realize it's the real heroes that walk out without a yearbook.
Exactly. I guess, yeah.
Very, very dramatic.
Yep.
But I kind of understand that. I do get that, because I think that many of us have gone through that. Is that where we either try to get everyone's approval and then eventually we catch ourselves either ostracizing ourselves or being ostracized. And then you catch yourself in this new niche, which is actually true to yourself. But sometimes you also need to go to that. You need to re-find yourself. You need to redefine yourself, only to realize that there were some people in the past who matter more now than they ever did.
Yeah.
You get that?
Yeah. But when I came to AS, I didn't really think about this specifically.
Yeah.
I was just, mujhe naye dost banane. Mujhe like, at least koi to dost banao main. So, after
koi
like...
Koi to mujhe cool bole.
Haan, koi to mujhe like, you know...
Lift kara de
thodi si. Yeah, koi bhi. So, main seniors ke saath bahut banti thi meri. Like, I used to have like hours of conversation with the seniors about random stuff. So, seniors se banti. But when they left after A2, I didn't really have anyone pair. But then I found ke, like, for example, I was the head of the photography society in Cedar, right?
I remember that.
Usse mujhe Dania Lotia mil gaya. And wagera. And hamara pura friend group ban gaya. Then more people came and we, like, you know, ho gaya phir. Achanak. I don't really remember how I met half of my friends. But like, just happened.
So, very organically.
And then at the same time, I met you. Because you were the patron of the photography society. So I used to have like, I used to bother you every day. Pehle to kaam ki bata deti, I just storm into your office. Just baat hi okay. Ek baar yaad bhi hai ke I like slammed the door. I slammed the door and like, you know, tuck, tuck, tuck. And I came in, you were super angry. You remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
I blamed it on Daniel. I came in and you thought it was Daniel, I think, right?
I don't remember who I thought it was, but I know I you know, blew a fuse.
So I'm like, shit. I was like, you know, pointing to Dania. So, what was I saying? Where was I?
Our journey.
Our journey. Then I used to bother you almost every day. Kaam ki baat bhi karte the. I used to give you like ideas for Cedars ke podcast or...
And you always used to, for all those listening, Ahad used to come in and actually give me... He was one of the people who I used to get a lot of my market research from. To see the content that, you know, the students would see and like what attracts them. And but one thing I realized very quickly was that Ahad was an anomaly. He didn't watch the things that many kids watched. Many kids would be caught up in watching their naughty little things on YouTube. He was learning. He was learning about those naughty little things on YouTube. That's just a joke. He still doesn't know what these naughty little things are.
I'm just chota. I'm 19, okay? I don't know the world. I was really different, like, in terms of what I watched. I watched, like, you know, similar stuff to what you watched, like, you know, entrepreneurship or Jordan Peterson.
Yeah.
lifestyle videos, vagera, vagera.
Like, you were watching things and you were consuming content which was of more substance, let's say that. The things that were helping
nothing
you grow.
Nothing like, you know, bullshit like, you know, Jake Paul or vagera, vagera.
Yeah.
I wasn't into that. Hmm. Even though some of my friends were like, you know, hype beasts. So they like this stuff. Hype beast is like I guess going with the trends.
Okay.
Like Supreme.
Yeah, I don't get that. I don't buy that stuff.
Huh, same.
It's weird. So tell me something. Is that when you were in A levels or in O levels, at any point in time, basically, do you ever feel that that you were alone in your journey? Do you ever feel that no one really got you?
I guess. I mean, there were a few people who I didn't even know myself at the time.
Yeah.
So other people had their worries or problems or like how to resolve them.
Yeah.
And I just agreed with it.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't really have anything like, you know, haan main aisa hoon aur ye banda bhi aisa hai. I didn't have that.
Yeah.
I was like, I had a similar experience and I'll try resolving it the way you resolved it. Sometimes it worked, sometimes it didn't. Aisa tha mera. I didn't really have any structured ke main aisa hoon and log ye banda bhi aisa hai. Aisa nahi tha mera, basically. Wait, what was your question?
Did you ever feel alone?
Feel alone? No, never.
No.
I always had people to talk to. I never really felt alone. Maybe in like AS mein, but that was only for like small amount of time. I really never felt alone. I had my family, I had really good friends. What I was really privileged because I knew people who I could talk to.
Yeah.
So I never really felt alone.
How did you develop this perspective? And because, again, I'm coming back to the anchor point of this conversation. It's more like you are my pawn for me to reflect into my past. All right? But like, how did you develop this perspective so early on?
Well, I remember when I got into like, you know, self-help.
Yeah.
So before Cedar started, I was watching videos on like, it's kind of embarrassing. Like I was watching videos on how to be confident, how to talk to people.
Because
I was really shy at the time. I was the quiet kid in your family who doesn't talk to anyone.
Okay.
Like,
the weird one.
Yeah, the weird one. Who just shaadi mein jata hai, ek kone mein baith jata hai. Kisi se baat nahi karta, khana kha ke chale jata hai. So I was that kid. I still am sometimes. I've gotten better, lekin us waqt aisa tha. So I was watching videos on how to talk to people, how to interact with in a new environment, how to build confidence.
Fair.
Confidence wala was the main thing. So I saw this video by this YouTuber. What's his name? Based Zeus. He said how to build your confidence. He had a lot of steps. Like in a step which really got me hooked was do 10 push-ups every morning after you wake up, like right after and before you go to sleep. Uske baad se, that's how I got into fitness in areas, and then I looked at, you know, how to maintain your mental health.
Okay.
That was because of Sir Salman. Salman Amin. So after that, I just like got into that path where I just started watching Jordan Peterson, vagera, vagera.
Yeah, yeah.
And less political stuff, more like, you know, how to focus on myself. I stress eat a lot. So in ASK exams, CI exams, during the whole month, exercise bilkul hi band ho gaye.
Yeah.
And I used to stress eat a lot. Like, din mein like 4-5 meals. And I gained weight after that. So then, thoda like, you know, mental. But before that, I was like itna fit tha yaar. I remember. Lekin abhi bhi, like, I've gotten
back. You
back
into running.
Yeah, abhi.
So yeah.
So my goal is to get back to my AS self.
Because
I feel like my AS self was more organized.
Yeah. So how do you think it was for you to transition into university?
and into university.
Yeah.
It was hard because A-levels, even though it's a new environment.
Yeah.
It's the same old people from defense in Clifton.
Yeah.
Which in majority of the time.
Yeah.
They were all from O-level backgrounds and stuff. So, thoda banta
tha. There were some
yeah.
factors which made you all like-minded individuals. Yeah.
So, I could just go up to someone and was like, tumhari O-level subjects kya the? Kaun si O-level school se aayo?
Yeah. And then you find some connection from
yeah, here. Yeah, like agar O-levels mein chemistry liya tha, then we used to just complain about chemistry.
Yeah, yeah.
University mein aake, there are different kya kehte hain, majors.
Yeah.
Different people, different backgrounds, inter ke log, A-levels mm-hmm. ke log, Aga Khan board, wagera, wagera.
Mm-hmm.
Really diverse background. So in the first month, I was that awkward kid again. You mm-hmm. know, side pe baithta hai, kisi se baat nahi karta.
Yeah.
Wo cycle continue.
Haan pe Pepsi.
Yeah. So I was just thinking, like, ek mahina hi hua, I'm in my second semester.
Yeah.
And phir bhi I reflect back and see ke, I was in the mindset ke, jaldi semester khatam ho jaye.
Yeah.
Or I just wanted to see ki university kaisi hai. And I didn't really focus on meeting people, like making friends. I just wanted to, you know, I knew Sir Naban phir bhi, like
more or less, huh?
Huh. But I just wanted to, like, you know, kaam karke ghar jaun.
But so now, how is it now? Is that ke
yeah, I
still same mindset?
Not really. Abhi Naban Kareem, who is the head of the media department, he told me the importance of networking. So, and following up with your advice that you gave me once, ke sab ke sab mana ke rakho. And I repeated that over and over in my head. I was like, bro, I need to interact more.
Yeah.
So I got a really nice group of friends from university. Bahut helpful hain, bahut acche. Even though I miss my senior friends more, like in university, like I think
you find
I can
yourself,
survive yeah. with them.
So now you, compared to 6 months ago, now you are a lot more comfortable.
Yeah. But like 6 months ago, I was in Cedar, which was like more comfortable.
Last semester.
Yeah.
Yeah. Compared to the start of the first semester to now the start of the second semester.
Definitely.
Yeah. A lot more comfortable.
Yeah.
You've managed to form friendships from outside of this A-level network.
And like have experiences. Because yeah. like main production side mein ja raha hu na, to in university Sir Naban, he had a lot of production projects which he made me a part of. So that usme experience bahut mila us pe, like, you know, I learned how to work with a team. Even though CDR mein bhi sikha tha, lekin isme like, you know,
this is actually like practical work.
Yeah,
this
practical
is very
work.
Hand real world stuff.
Yeah. Like, in a professional background, like Cedar May, like Daniel Lodi, I used to, like, you know, those tha vera, so I just like, you know, mazak karte the. Isme, like, you know, professional, you have to treat each other professionally.
Yeah, yeah.
Not too professional, like hasi mazak to hota hai.
Yeah, you
obviously.
Can't just mess about all the
yeah,
time.
Yeah, but you can't,
like,
mess
you
around.
You gotta get the job done.
Yeah, definitely.
Say, fair, cool, man. So now, if overall, all right, so like this is actually, there's two questions left to ask you.
Okay.
Is that because, but I also know you have some
yes.
set of questions for me as well. So I'm going to ask you one right now and I'll ask you one at the end of the episode.
Okay.
Is that overall, how do you feel that you've actually evolved since like Ahad from when he was in diapers to now? Like, you ever reflect, look back at the past and just reflect to see where you were, where you are now, how things have been for you?
I do reflect. I mean, from diapers to now, obviously, like,
you are now able to walk alone.
Yes.
You can put on your own panties.
Yes. Sometimes.
Yeah. And all that.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I don't really have much to say to, like, you know, my 5-year-old self or maybe my 8th grade self.
Yeah.
I'll just tell him to, like, you know, practice your Urdu and math. That's very important.
Practice Urdu and math. Okay.
Yeah, that's very important. University mein bahut kam aayega.
Yeah. No, but I mean, like, actually, like, do you ever look back and think that there were these people who I was attaching myself to who may have not been good for me, or you ever feel that you've wasted time, or you ever feel that, you know, I'm happy and I'm grateful for all the things that I did have to go through, because then I wouldn't be this person who I am today. You ever thought about that?
Yeah. But I didn't really see the people who I wanted to be associated with as bad people.
Yeah.
I saw them as, like, I didn't really see them as anything. Okay. I just like they're alone. Main apne aap ko abhi dekhta hun ke I used to be like that. Mm. I used to try to impress people. I wanted to have that attention.
Yeah.
I thought ki agar attention milegi, then I would be good in my studies. I would have a really good life, wagera, wagera.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like that at all. And I wish I could tell my 8th to 9th grade, maybe 10th grade self, ke stop, just focus on yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Don't care about what other people can, other people think. Because I didn't realize at the time, but like O-level social life was like everything to me.
Yeah.
Grades be not that important.
Mm-hmm.
Social life and the way people looked at you was more important to me.
Hmm.
Now I realize I was like an idiot.
Yeah.
Why I focused on people and serve myself.
Yeah.
I can care at least like I got it early on, like in A-levels. Because most of the people, abhi bhi, even in university, they're trying to be part of like, you know, the popular group.
Yeah.
Kiss ass all the time.
Yeah.
I'm not saying kissing ass is a bad thing. I mean, sometimes it works, but you're not true
if to yourself. If it's not genuine, then it's not genuine. Worth it then, yeah.
Yeah. So like teachers ke saath kar sakte ho, wagera, wagera. Yeah, you can
just
do that.
To get by.
Yeah. Hmm. But like, maine bahut dekha ye hai ki you're just like, you know, teacher pe haan milate ho, even though they're in the wrong, phir bhi unki side le rahe ho tum, which is kind of wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Even though your beliefs are different, you're not voicing them.
Yeah.
And you're just...
Be true to yourself, basically. Exactly. Yeah. Be true to your identity.
Yeah, exactly. Or don't be, I would say, ke grades ke liye sirf haan pe haan mila rahe ho. Don't do that.
Fair.
If agar teacher se banti hai, banao. Nahi banti, chhod do. Don't try to impress someone who doesn't give two shits about you.
Yeah.
Toh, yeah.
And not just teachers, anyone in general, I feel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless it's like, you know, if it's that situation where you have to.
Mm-hmm.
Like, aise situations aate hain ke you really need that person to like you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for example, maybe, kya kehte hai usko, investors.
Yeah.
Or someone important that could get you somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Like, promotion mil sakti hai. I'm not saying ke kiss their ass completely.
Yeah.
But it's helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Like, kar sakte ho.
Yeah.
You have to be thoda sa, like, outside your comfort zone. Mm-hmm. You can't be too comfortable all the time.
Yeah.
Or you just seem like a dick.
Yeah. True.
So, yeah.
So, what did you want to ask me?
Huh. Okay. First, I'm getting back into fitness.
Sorry, one second. How are you liking this experience so far?
It's amazing, you're a jittery, dude. No?
Like, it's fun, isn't it?
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah?
Like it's like conversation. I select that, you know?
And it's real, right? You don't have the camera in front of you, then...
Yeah. And like I'm just thinking ke na, like log, I hope ke log ye na sahi samjhe ye wagera wagera.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Sorry, let's go. What do you want to ask me?
So, I recently got back into fitness. Mm-hmm. Pehle fitness ka tha, but I lost my way.
Yeah.
So, I want to... Bodybuilding mein hi tha, I just want to take care of myself and feel good.
Yeah.
But also look good.
Okay.
So, if I'm a fitness amateur, main ab tak sirf cardio kar raha hun aur kuch bhi nahi kar raha hun.
Yeah.
I haven't even lifted anything.
Yeah.
So, what do you suggest I start with, or like your experience when you started?
Yeah.
What did you do?
So when I started off, okay, so firstly, I'm no fitness professional.
Hmm.
And I don't know if I told you this, but I was a trainer in our community.
Yeah.
For a couple of years, actually, around 14 months to be exact. And even then, whatever advice I'd give, I'd always tell them, like, look, you can't take what I'm saying, like, exactly. Do your own research as well.
Hmm.
If it's about making a meal plan, make sure you're eating balanced diets. You know, make sure your diet is balanced. Make sure that you are getting the right nutritional intake that you need. But at the same time, do your research as well. Information exists in the world, all right? But then also remember is that if there's a professional giving you advice, the person's a professional for a reason.
Hmm.
They've done their research. They've done their hustle in this. They've grinded it out completely to know what they're saying.
Yeah.
And they're just like every other field, there's also opposing views, right? But for me personally, when I started out, I started off exactly the way you're saying, okay, just do a lot of cardio as well.
Yeah.
So if I'd go to the gym, I'd spend around an hour and a half at the gym. I'd do maybe 45 minutes to an hour's worth of cardio and 30 minutes of lifting weights. But then after that, I wouldn't eat. I think that, you know, you have to go on a... I knew about going on a caloric deficit where you eat as less as possible. But...
You're supposed to eat right after the exercise.
You're supposed to eat after you work out.
What if you want to lose weight?
You still eat Pirdi. After. Yeah, because you need to get your glycogen levels back up. What happens is that you're using glucose, right? And you need to then start... You need to replenish your body as well. So, but again, that doesn't mean is that after you work out, you deserve a burger. Basically means is that you got to eat something or the other. You got to make sure that you can help your body recover, your muscles recover as well. And another thing which I also... want to do let you know is that if you run behind aesthetics, you're gonna get caught in this weird spiral.
Not aesthetics, mainly like
remember this, sorry, you if you start feeling good, you will start looking good as well, because you think you look good, and that is this level of self-confidence which just ends up reeking out of you, right? If I want to tell you this superficially, if you think you're sexy, everyone else is going to think you're sexy as well. Because that's a level of self-confidence that you, you know, let out. But if you think you look like shit and someone thinks that you look good, you're not going to believe them. Or people are going to think you look like shit as well.
Yeah.
Either or.
Hmm.
You know? Fun fact, when I was a kid, I used to pray to God as that kid to help me get thinner and taller.
Same.
And I don't think I got taller than I was supposed to. But a couple of years ago in the gym, out of the shower, I was looking myself in the mirror and I was like, whoa, dude, this is exactly what I want to look like when I was like 7th grade or 6th grade or something. And I was like, whoa, man, like I feel like, you know, I'm like Captain America right now, or I'm like Iron Man right now, you know. So it's like, it's a level of confidence that you end up building. But the point is just do it. Do your research and start doing it, you know. And make sure you make it a regular habit. It's not a marathon. It's not a sprint. You know? You have to take it one day at a time. It can't end so quickly. You want to get a set of abs? You can set a timeline. You can get those abs. But then also, it's at what cost? Are you going to beat yourself up with building up on anxiety related to food and dietary habits? Or are you going to get caught up on what people think of you? You know? So... That's my take on it.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Damn it. Changed my mind.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fun fact also, by the way, if you even want to explore different sports also, and sports doesn't mean football, basketball, cricket, squash, swimming. Sports within lifting weights also. You could go into powerlifting. You could go into power building. You could go into bodybuilding. You could go into CrossFit. You could get into Olympic lifting. And the more you get into these sports, you'll realize that there are different body types for every sports and for every sport. And there's a specific body type which is going to have an advantage over another body type. That's natural. That's genetics. But then also you start realizing is that, okay, fine. Majority of the power lifters who are benching like 400, 500 pounds and squat and squatting like 700 to 800 pounds and deadlifting like 700-800 pounds. These guys are huge, massive people, right? Like the guy that guy from Iceland who's Thor.
Yeah.
Jo Game of Thrones maybe tha. I think he was in Game of Thrones. But you know what I'm talking about, right? This huge, tall guy, right? He you see majority of the people like massive like him. But then also, the more you dig into the sport, you'll find a thin, scrawny dude or a girl squatting 650, 700 pounds, deadlifting 550, 600, 700 pounds, benching like 300, 400 pounds. That's great. That's powerlifting. And that's powerlifting in their weight class. We get caught up in thinking, okay, there's a specific body type which we need to get to achieve a specific goal. But then we forget the fact that there's a way to train yourself also to still look the exact same or get that physique you want while being able to do all that cool shit that these other athletes are doing. You know what I'm saying?
So
stuff like that.
So when you got into fitness, did you pre-plan everything?
So initially, up until... Okay, sorry. From the start till now, I've always tried to maintain a program. And initially, I was looking online for different programs and different weightlifting programs as well. And then I just started programming on my own, because I realized what the fundamentals were. I realized was that, okay, you have to, there's certain exercises you have to repeat on a regular basis, like the compound movements, and then you also have to do progressive overload, which is increasing the weights progressively. to build that strength also. And then also I started realizing, okay, fine, it's not only about increasing the weights, it's also about messing around with the rep range as well, because then that affects your training program also. And then I started realizing there's also this concept of muscle memory. Is that if you do the same exact exercise routine for a year, you might not get the same results because you have to shock your muscles. And uspe bhi ek theory aati hai ki that's all bullshit, ke shocking your muscles and muscle memory and falana timkana. But let's not get into that. Find a program that you think you can do and follow and do it. I start off my lifestyle change. When I was doing fitness as a lifestyle change, I started doing calisthenics.
Calisthenics.
Yeah, and that was like just doing bodyweight stuff at home. I downloaded an app and I was doing that for a couple of months. And then I went to a class by these two guys. One was Hydro, who has his own gym called Hydro Fit Team on Shahbaz. And another guy was Usman Yaqub, who's moved to Lahore. And I went to their facility. Classes were thrice a week. And I absolutely loved it because we were flipping tires. We were like, you know, going on monkey bars. We were using kettlebells. It wasn't that typical, let's do bicep curls now. Aww. Let's do benches now. I was like, I thought this was crap. I actually wanted to see what my body could do. And I learned that from there. And then I took that and I formed their program into what I was training people to do as well. And then I also incorporated that style. And now I do CrossFit. And if anything, I'm nowhere where I wanted to be somewhere else in my journey, but it's okay if I haven't met that goal yet, because I don't want it to be my life. I want it to be a part of my life.
Huh.
You know?
That's a nice way to look at it, actually.
Yeah.
Okay, so the other question that I wanted to ask is, why did you go towards media? Like, is it something that you planned to do, or is it just something that you fell into?
I fell into it.
How?
So during university, I thought that, and before university, I thought that I was going to get into the corporate world or the entrepreneurial world.
Yeah.
Very frankly. There were a couple of things which happened in life which made me not take that route. Right? And media was just something which came along. While I was at Cedar, when Cedar was being made, I was one of the first few people to join the team. And also being the youngest, I think I was given the major pile of the grunt work that had to be done, which was also then taking pictures and taking care of social media. So they basically taught me how to do these things. And then they saw, he knows what we want and how we do things. He's part of us. He's one of us. And he also has the skills, the basic skills. And then from there, career in media and communications ended up developing. Otherwise, I thought I was going to get into consultancy. Frankly.
Yeah.
And I still think I will. Don't get me wrong. This is just the first of many things that I do, that I want to do, that I am doing. There's a lot to come. Hopefully this won't die out for me to have to move on to the next thing. I want to be able to make sure that this is alive and doing well. Backspace is doing well and is alive and is thriving while I move on to the next project, whatever that may end up being.
So I know that you have a lot of goals that keep changing and you keep adding more goals.
Yeah.
But is there just that one goal that you always keep in your list?
That I always keep in my list?
Yeah. That you want to achieve in the future?
A chain of restaurants and a chain of schools.
Ah, okay. Yeah, mine is just like traveling the world.
See, this is the entrepreneurial goal.
Hmm.
That's for me, this is the entrepreneurial goal. I ended up sounding like a bit of an asshole, capitalistic asshole about this as well. But and if I didn't, then I guess I'm feeding too into it. No, about life, I think one of my major goals is just basically to make sure that my family, my current family, my future family, health is well and happiness is high. I need to make sure bale jo bhi ho jaye zindagi mein, making sure that everyone is doing well and that we're all in a very good place, you know?
Yeah. That's more focused on like your family.
Yeah.
Right? But what about you?
Making sure that happens.
Making sure that, okay.
Making sure that happens.
Huh.
That's a goal of mine.
Okay.
You know, like I've seen a lot of sacrifices that my parents have had to make, that me and my brother have had to make. And I just want to make sure that I don't have to sacrifice anymore, frankly speaking. If I do, then of course, like, I'm not shying away from having to make sacrifices, but what I'm trying to say is that I hope is that me and my brother and my parents and my brother's future kids and my future kids we all are just doing well, and that we're constantly grateful, and that there's no bad blood amongst each other. There's no troubles, whether that be financial or health-wise or anything like that. You know, sukoon hona chahiye zindagi mein.
Yeah.
And like an ultimate level of sukoon, which is probably never attainable because life is just a little shit. You know, there's going to be ups and downs. But just making sure that there's no major obstacle which comes our way, which might like derail us.
Yeah.
Because we've had that. And that's not a pretty place to be in. So that's the goal.
So us a junior will be proud.
Yeah. You better be, bastard.
Yeah. Okay, so a similar question to what you asked me.
Yeah.
But it's a little different. So you started Backspace a while ago, like
over a year. It's been over a year. Yeah.
So what would you tell Asad when he was starting Backspace? What would you go back and tell him?
One of the major things, I remember when I was making Backspace, I was talking to one of my mentors about this. I literally had a pros and cons list set up. The only con, one of those very few cons, which was there. The first one was financial security. And the second one was that risk of failure, fear of failure, you know? So basically risk was a thing. So I tell myself is that that's, you wanted to get into this entrepreneurial life, man. It's full of risks. Yeah. You got to take it. You want, if you feel instinctually it's the right thing to do, then go for it. Allah Malika. You know, it'll all sort out.
So you mentioned your mentors, and one of the biggest mentors I think I've seen that you, who you interacted with, Bilal Hamid.
Yeah.
So what attracted you to Sir Bilal?
Yeah, I think it's the fact is that we have very similar stories. We have very similar stories, me and him. And he sees this, I think he has this, or he sees this desire of mine to want to reach new heights and like, you know, defy all odds and like, you know, go the extra mile. He sees that I'm going to do that, and he sees this potential in me, which is why maybe he's also investing his time in me. But I also see the journey that he's been on, and I can understand that. I can relate to that also because it's a very similar journey. You wouldn't get on that journey if you didn't have something that was really hard hitting in your life to put you there. Because, you know, he was also in the, he was a grammarian. Before that, he was in Paul's. And then, you know, he's traveled the world as well growing up, similar to me. You know, our stories, they have differences. But the base similarity, the things that bring us together is the fact that we basically had to take control into our own hands really early on. So that is something that I think that, you know, really gets us to gel well together. And then that's formed, that relationship formed from him being my boss to him then becoming like an angel in disguise to him then, you know, becoming a mentor. And now I don't even like to call him a mentor. I like to call him like a brother. Because I said to him a couple of nights ago, I was like, dude, who else is there in the world right now? I was like, you know, if your daughter calls me Chachu and your wife calls me Beta, it's a really weird relationship going on here. But like, it's like we're family, man. Like, you know, he calls me out on shit left, right and center. I call him out on shit left, right and center. And then, you know, we smack each other and then we go home. That's how it is, man.
That's a good relationship.
Yeah.
So you both have been through a specific journey that you both relate to.
We both relate to,
so do you think more people should have that turning point, or do you think they can survive without it in today's time?
I think you can survive without it.
But
I think it's very important for you to, it's very important for you to know about these stories and know about these journeys, because
it makes you realize
something that I always tell people when I tell people my story and my journey. And I think I've told you briefly ke kya hua tha, one-on-one. And I always say is that it's a privilege to have gone through all of this, is because that what I learned at this, at the age of 21, from between 10 and 22 years of age, while I was 10 years old, I feel like that's when my story started. So between 10 and 22, the things that I've learned, I just feel that I'm blessed to have learned it so early on, is because when people face these problems when they're 30, 40, 50 years old, they then end up losing hope, or they end up, you know, like God forbid, going into a really dark place. They don't know what to do. And I'm fortunate because I learned it early on. So, khuda na khasta ye cheez kabhi aur aaye, matlab phir se aaye meri zindagi mein, then I know how to deal it. I know how to deal with it. I know how to get out of that sticky situation. I know how to make sure that how to navigate through all of this as well. You know, and I think that's just really defined me as an individual. You know, I think that's one of the major reasons, like, learning these lessons are very important. I feel you don't have to go through that. I hope no one ever has to go through that. I hope never, no one ever has to see that side of life. But I hope that people can actually understand, okay, there's some things that you have to take a little seriously. And you might want to be free-spirited, or you might want to travel the world and, you know, be a digital nomad, or you might want to, you know, go out and party all night every day of the week. But there's going to come a point in time when you're going to have to get your shit together and just get shit done. And no complaining.
Do you think there's a specific time, like, you should focus on that early on?
Or I think it's something to do with your parents.
Parents?
Yeah, your parents got to teach you these things. My parents got to teach you these values.
Yeah.
As if my parents didn't raise me this way, then I could have just walked out of every situation that went on at home. I was going, screw you, mom and dad, I'm out. It's not my problem, it's your problem.
That's a lot of people these days.
And I'm no one to say, okay, yaar, aap jo kar rahe ho, sahi kar rahe ho, galat kar rahe ho. But
you're more of a realist.
Call it for what it is, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's how I see it.
Okay, so I have like two more questions.
Okay.
Okay, so these are like really simple.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you like Pakistan, Karachi?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
I do.
Why? There's a lot.
Okay, so the typical economic answer is like, yeah, bahut scope hai yahan Pakistan mein, bahut scope hai Karachi mein. But I think that the reason why I like it is because my brother came from London recently. I went to go meet him. He flew back with me. Our relationship, he came last year as well. And this year, my mom, my dad, me and him both, we were like, mine and my brother's relationship has changed into something very different now. And it's great to see, because I feel like he's not even like, he sees my strengths, I see his strengths, and we know how to fill in for each other's weaknesses now. Pehle was like, ha ha, you fucked up, you know, but now it's like, now there's this level of trust which has evolved. You always trust your family members, but now it's like a solid bond, I feel. And he said to me, he's like, hey, dude, I'm really like impressed at how you've done everything you've done. Like, I see your life. I see the way you have Backspace going. I see the way you deal with all these clients and stuff. It's amazing. And then I was like, why are you saying this? He's like, because you have something that I don't think I have, which is what? Like, resilience and grit. That's why I like Karachi in Pakistan. I think it helps you make that. You end up becoming really hardcore. You know, you end up building or growing a thicker skin. There's a lot of pitfalls. There's a lot of issues with the country and with the city. And I'm not going to sugarcoat it. It is what it is. Take it. You get blacklisted from literally many different situations, whether that's from immigration in another foreign country, or that's getting a job, or that's the stigma of you looking Indian and being Indian. But like, it's just that, see, the reason why I like it more now is because I know that there are a lot of issues here. There are a lot of issues in people. But if you end up becoming like the herd, who's going to lead the sheep then?
Yeah. You know? I get that.
So me going to this trip in December, coming back with new ideas, coming back with a fresher perspective, coming back with a new approach, I can already see that changing my behavior. I can already see that, how that's affecting so many other variables in my life. Not just the teaching side, but like the work side, especially the work side. The ideas as well, the formulating those ideas, understanding the importance of things as well. Many things, like even with my own personal health. But I can see that feeding off on people, you know? And then there's that, you just end up influencing other people in a positive way. So I don't know if that's answering the question.
It is kind of, because like you're saying that the environment, like that is Karachi, that kind of influenced your life and your experiences.
It did. And for a while, I used to think that Karachi is a very toxic city. I do think it's a toxic city. Don't get me wrong. But I think is that I was fortunate enough to have gone abroad. I was fortunate enough to have lived abroad for a long time and then come in with a different perspective. you know, and come in with a different mindset altogether and offer that perspective and mindset over here, which is why I feel that that lets me be, you know, set myself apart from many others. Mm. And if everyone can get that level of exposure, you can make this city and this country and this culture a lot better.
Yeah.
You know, in terms of your professional growth, or that's education, or that's healthcare, or that's just like, you know, basic tarbiyat, you know, mm. you can really improve that. But it would be even better is that if there were many more people who were equally exposed, if not more.
Hmm.
That's what I feel.
Good answer.
Yeah.
Okay, last question. I know that you organize yourself and your daily life according mm-hmm. to a plan. Mm-hmm. So you'll give this much time to, like, let's say, fitness, this yeah. much time to work, personal life, wagera, wagera.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of structure for you regularly.
Yeah.
Do you like organizing and structuring your life? As say, like, do you have a craving ke na thora sa unexpected chalta hai? Do you have that, or do you like
organizing? See, I want it to be organized. I like things being spontaneous.
Hmm.
But I do need structure.
Were you always like...
Yeah. Organized. I always had this, like... From in school, my notebooks had to be in a particular way. If I ever wrote in one other notebook for... If I ever wrote in my math notebook for economics, then I would rip that page out, either staple it onto my economics journal or recopy everything there. Things had to be organized that way. Mm. But then I just realized, like, yeah, it's very important for you to write things down. Whether you're working or... My life is all about work. That's, you know... I'm not going to give you any, like, philosophical answer about this. But, like, it's just... one of my first few bosses at Lyceum actually gave me a notebook, gave me a journal, gave me two pens, red and black. It says, high priority is red, and day-to-day tasks are in black. Put a star, do whatever the fuck you want to do. And I did that. And then that was like, okay, I need to maintain this habit. You know, so, like, even now, there's many times where I catch myself feeling really, like, unstructured and unorganized. So you'll find... 3 different notebooks in my bag, along with an iPad, along with a Google Calendar and a reminder section and all of that stuff. And then this base camp, like task managers and everything.
Yeah.
But it's in my head ki haan ye cheez maine dal di hai, ye maine kahan dali thi exactly, and ye kis tarah chal raha hai. And I'm pretty set with that. People ask me ki yaar, what's your bank account number? I know where to go exactly and pull out my bank account.
Yeah, yeah.
People ask me ki yaar, where is this video stored? Where what's the file name? Stuff. I know exactly ki yaar, in this file, there you go. So, like, you have to have... I feel that I need to have that. I don't know if everyone has to have that, but you need to physically see what do you have to do, what are your things to do, and there you go. But when it comes to fitness, my workouts and my programming is done physically as well. It's just that this past month, I've been making workouts on the spot, but I like to program and structure out my daily workout. But I don't put that into my calendar. I'm not uber organized that way. It's like I need to monitor my time and be like, yeah, 45 minutes means 45 minutes, not 44 minutes, not 46 minutes.
Hmm.
I'm not that type of person. I'm not super anal about it.
Yeah.
You know, because for me, working out is something that is a part of my life. It's not, you know, something that I need to do in the near short term or long term or something. It's like sleeping. You're not going to schedule in your sleeping, na?
Yeah.
You're not going to put it on your calendar. Ki, yaar, abhi maine sona hai, phir mujhe abhi itne baje uthna hai. It's the same way.
Hmm. Okay, yeah, that's it for this podcast. Thanks for tuning in, guys.
Thank you.
Taking over.
Yeah, taking over. And there's a reason why people used to think you look like me in school.
I don't see it.
I don't see it either. But people did say that, right?
Yeah, I think only Amina Zoom. I forgot her last.
Zoomka wala. Yeah.
Okay, I thought it was something else. Amina Zoomka wala and Dania Lotia were the only ones who said, "Oh, you look."
Like,
I didn't see it. Yeah. Like, maybe, I don't know, the forehead. But
the
that's
forehead?
It. Yeah, we that's have similar it. Foreheads.
Okay, that's...
But that's it.
That's awfully particular.
Yep.
Thanks for coming by, buddy.
Yeah, man.
Thank you so much. I hope you had a good time.
I did. I learned a lot.
Mm-hmm. And for all those listening, I think Ahad actually got some juice out of me about my life.
Yes, I did.
So, if that matters, then hope you enjoyed it. But once again, thank you, Ahad. Till the next time, see you guys. Hope you have a great week, day, month. Don't know when the next episode's coming out / whatever ahead. And till then, peace out. Bye-bye.